Am I in the habit of making vows? There are so many people, for every small things they promise to God. I remember one lady, she promised, because when the child was having some fever or something and it was not getting healed, the child was not getting healed, so she promised and said, I will carry this child and will go to Valangani shrine and I will carry with my hand all the way and surrender my child in the Valangani shrine, Mother Mary's shrine. And she promised, and after some time, anyway, the child got healed, and then she postponed the promises. Now the child is more than 22 years old. I don't know how she is going to fulfill that promise, carrying this 22-year-old man from home to Valangani shrine. It's impossible. And now she is struggling. And then in the confession, she has to do the confession and beg for forgiveness. And in the confession, the priest will reduce the vow and make it as a small symbolic gesture. And then she went and confessed, and the priest told, okay, instead of carrying the whole person, just you carry a small crucifix of Jesus and a picture of your son and go and offer for pilgrimage. So this is how she somehow managed to escape from this fulfillment of the vow. Sometimes we take unnecessary vows, and after taking vows, we forget about this. The Lord wants us not to take vows unnecessarily. So we only when there is necessary needs. So we read like this, Sirach chapter 18, verse 22 and 23. We read like this, Sirach 18, 22 and 23. Let nothing hinder you from paying a vow promptly, and do not wait until death to be released from it. Before making a vow, prepare yourself. Do not be like one who puts the Lord to the test. Don't do by testing God every time putting vows. But before you do that, do it sincerely, only what is practical. Don't take any vow which is not so practical. Sirach 23 verse 11. Sirach 23 verse 11. We read like this. Sirach 23 verse 11. The one who swears many oaths is full of iniquity, and the scourge will not leave his house. If he swears in error, his sin remains on him. And if he disregards it, he sins doubly. If he swears a false oath, he will not be justified, for his house will be filled with calamities. So these are the warnings which God wants to give us for unnecessary vows and oaths that we take.